Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to install and update the drivers on Windows 10 and Windows 11. It's very important that you have the correct drivers installed in Windows to ensure that your computer runs as efficient and optimal as it possibly can at all times, and that there's proper communication between the hardware of your computer and Windows itself. Now, to keep track of the drivers that are installed on your computer, whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, go down to your Start button and then right-click on it. And then you want to find the Device Manager on this list, and you can click on that. This will open the Device Manager on your computer. And here is an example of what the Device Manager should look like if you have all the proper drivers installed in Windows. You shouldn't be seeing any yellow exclamation marks or any driver or hardware errors in Device Manager, and it should look exactly like this. Now, there are a few different ways that you can use to get all of the proper drivers installed on your system, and that's what I'm going to be showing you in this guide. So what you can expect from this guide is how to install drivers using Windows Update, how to manually install drivers on your computer by downloading them from the manufacturer's website, and at the end of the video, I'll also show an advanced method that you can use to identify and install missing drivers if you have absolutely no idea what the driver is that you need to install on your system. So to install drivers through Windows Update, whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, go to your Start menu and then open Settings on your computer. And then you want to find the Update and Security tab, or just the Windows Update tab if you're using Windows 11. If your computer isn't already automatically downloading updates, you can go ahead and check for updates. And some of the drivers will automatically be downloaded and installed. For example, this Intel graphics driver. But all of the other drivers will be found in the View Optional Updates tab. And sometimes before you can see the optional updates, you first have to install all of the other Windows updates, and then that option will be available. But if you click into the optional updates, you'll see there's a driver updates tab, and you can click on that to expand it. And here you'll see a whole list of drivers that Windows has identified that should be installed on your system. So now you can go ahead and select all of these checkboxes. And once that's done, you can just click on Download and Install. And now Windows Update will download and install all of those drivers through the Windows Update. So you can just wait for the download and installation process to finish, and then go ahead and restart your computer. Once you've restarted your computer, you can come back to Windows Update and check for updates again to see if it found any other drivers that should be installed. And once there aren't any other drivers to be downloaded and installed via Windows Update, you can go to your Device Manager and then check if all of the drivers have been installed on your computer. Starting on a desktop computer, go ahead and do a search for system information, and the system information app should be the best match, and you can go ahead and click into that. And then on this list, you want to have a look at your baseboard manufacturer and baseboard product. So I have a Gigabyte B450 Aorus Elite V2, and with that info, I'll come over to Google and then do a search for that motherboard with the word drivers included. And then you want to make sure that you're downloading the drivers from your motherboard manufacturer's website and not from any other website. So I'll go ahead and click into this one, which is the webpage for my motherboard. And although I'm explaining how to do this on a Gigabyte motherboard, most of the motherboard manufacturer's websites mostly function the same. So once you're on the downloads page for your motherboard, you can go over and you can choose the operating system that you have installed on your computer. On this computer, I have Windows 10 64-bit, so I'll go ahead and select that. And then you'll have the drivers listed here. So as you can see, for the audio driver, there are multiple audio drivers listed here, and that's how these drivers have been updated, as you can see by the date that they were uploaded. So you'll have a section for audio, and if you scroll all the way down, you can find the other drivers for your motherboard as well. Now for this tutorial, I'm not going to be downloading and installing all the drivers, but in your case, you want to download the latest driver inside of each category. For example, if we open the chipset driver, you'll have multiple drivers, and always download the latest available one. For example, here I have an AMD chipset driver for this motherboard, and down here I also have an AMD chipset driver, but obviously this is the latest version, so always go ahead and download the latest available version. So for this tutorial, I'll just go ahead and download this AMD chipset driver, and I'll click on this download link to download it. Once the download is finished, you can just go ahead and open the folder so you can find it in your downloads folder. And most of the time, these drivers will be in a zip file, so you'll need a file extraction software like 7-zip to extract these drivers. And once you've done that and you open the extracted folder, you'll find the driver inside of it. So I'm just going to double click on this to launch it, and it'll then start installing the driver that I just downloaded. The driver installation is now finished. And just to be clear, like I said before, you need to download all the latest available drivers that you have for your motherboard. In this example, I only show you how to download and install one of these drivers, but you need to download and install all of the latest ones available so you can get all of the drivers installed on your desktop computer. To download the drivers from a laptop manufacturer's website, you can also go down to search and then do a search for system information and then open the system information app. And for a laptop on this list, what you want to have a look at is the system manufacturer and the system model. So this is an Acer Aspire A315-53. But in most cases, to get the correct drivers for your laptop, you'll need to have the serial number and then enter it on the laptop manufacturer's website. So to do that, if you have a newer computer, you can right-click on your start button, whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, and then open up Windows PowerShell or Terminal as admin. And once you've done that, you can enter this command to get the serial number from your BIOS, and this will give you the serial number of your laptop. If you enter this command and you don't get any value or you don't get any serial number here, it means you'll physically have to look for the serial number on your computer. So you'll need to turn off your laptop, turn it around, and then take a picture of the serial number so you can go ahead and use it in the next step. I'm just going to go ahead and copy the serial number. Then I'm going to open up my browser and do a Google search for Acer laptop drivers because I have an Acer laptop. You just need to replace Acer with your motherboard manufacturer. So I'll go ahead and do a search, and then you want to find your laptop manufacturer's download and support page. Now, like I said before, most laptop manufacturers require you to either enter the serial number or model number of the laptop. And this is where we'll enter the serial number that we got by running this command. So I'll just paste that serial number and then press enter so it can find my product on the manufacturer's website. And that is the laptop that I'm currently using. And on the laptop manufacturer's webpage, you'll also find a drivers and downloads section, and you can choose the operating system that you're using. Apparently the only option here is Windows 10 64-bit. But even if you only have this option available and you have Windows 11 installed, like what I have here, you can still go ahead and download these drivers and install them on Windows 11 and they'll still work perfectly fine. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this drivers tab to expand it. And here we have all the available drivers that we can download, and it also lists the category that they're in. And you'll need to download and install all of the missing drivers on your system. But for this video, I'm just going to go ahead and download the card reader driver. So I'll go ahead and click on download. Once it's finished, I'll just show it in my downloads folder. And then I can right click on this and extract the files. And once it's finished extracting, I'll just open up the folder. And then inside of all of these files, you always want to have a look for a file called setup, which is an application. So I'll go ahead and double click on the setup application. And this will launch the installation wizard for this driver. Just accept any user account control prompts. And then it will start installing the driver. And once it's finished, you can just go ahead and do this with all of the other available drivers that you need to install on your system. So on this computer, I have a few missing drivers, and I'm going to show you how I identify them. So in Device Manager, you can right click on the device and then go to Properties. And then you want to go to the Details tab, and under the property value, you want to change that to Hardware IDs. And then you want to right click on that ID and then copy it. And then you want to paste that hardware ID into Google and do a Google search for that hardware ID. And once you do that, you'll find a list of results. The first result should be the correct result. And when you do searches for drivers like this, you always want to try and download them from a laptop manufacturer's website or a motherboard manufacturer's website and not any other third-party website. So I found this missing driver on the Dell website, and I can trust this driver, so I'm going to download it. And then once it's finished downloading, I'll just find it in my downloads folder and then double click on it to run it, and then go through all of the normal driver installation setup screens. Now this driver extracted to the following location. It's on the C drive under the Dell folder and then drivers, and then that specific folder right there. So I'll navigate to that folder, and inside of that folder, I'll find the setup file which I need to run to install the driver. So I'll launch that, and then the driver installation will start. And you can just go through all of the normal driver installation setup screens. Once it's finished installing, the device that I was unable to identify is now installed. So just to recap, you select the device and then right click on it, go to properties, Go to the Details tab and then change the property to Hardware IDs, and then copy that Hardware ID and paste it into Google. And then you should find drivers for that specific device. Now I just quickly want to show you two bonus methods that you can use to install drivers via the device manager specifically. If you come over to any of these categories and you double click on it, it'll open the category and then show you the devices that's listed under that category. Now what you can do is you can right click on any of these items and then you can click on update driver. And then you can choose this option that says search automatically for drivers. And then it'll search for any available drivers it can install for the specific device. And sometimes it won't be able to find anything better than the generic drivers that are already installed. From here, you can also click on this option that says search for updated drivers on Windows Update, which will basically take you back to what we did at the start of the guide. The second method is to install the driver manually, and you can do that by right-clicking on it and then clicking on Update Driver. And then you can choose this option that says Browse My Computer for Drivers. Now you can browse to the folder where the driver is saved on your computer. And always make sure that this box is checked, which says Include Subfolders. Now typically you'll use this method if you have a driver which doesn't have any setup that you can run. So basically it only has a driver info file and no file that you can run to install the driver. So for instance, let's just say that this setup file didn't exist and we didn't know how to install this driver. You would use this method, and I'm going to click on Browse so I can navigate to where this driver is installed on my computer, and that is on my local disk C in the temp folder and then in this 24GM77 driver folder. So I'll click on Browse and then I'll scroll all the way down on my local disk C until I find the temp folder, and then inside the temp folder I have this folder, the 24GM77 driver, which is the driver for my monitor that I'm trying to install, and then I'll click on OK. And then on next, and then Windows will find the correct driver for that device inside of the folder and successfully install or update the driver. Now lastly, you can also use third-party tools to install drivers on your system. I prefer not to use these tools, so I'm not going to include them in this video. I wanted to explain how you can install drivers using Windows Update, and if Windows Update can't install the drivers for you, then you can download and install these drivers manually. I do hope this guide helped you out. Please like the video and watch any of my other helpful guides on this channel, and I'll see you in the next one.